Pleasant good morning to all our viewers, both at home and abroad. I greet you in the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. On this episode of Moments of Inspiration, Outreach Initiative of the Presbyterian Church of Trinidad and Tobago. I am Hendrickson H. Hublal, the principal of Rochard Douglas Presbyterian School. This morning, members of our staff and students are blessed with a wonderful opportunity of sharing in this worship experience dedicated to our S.E.A. students with a message delivered by Right Reverend Daniel Chance, moderator of the Presbyterian Church of Trinidad and Tobago and a past student of Rochard Douglas Presbyterian School. As we continue on our Lenten journey, let me first take this opportunity to invite Mrs. Suzanne Aaron-Basdeo, Acting Vice Principal, to share in a brief history of the Rochard Douglas Presbyterian Primary School and the Rochard Douglas Presbyterian Church.
A people without the knowledge of their past, origin, and culture is like a tree with no roots. The Rochard Douglas Presbyterian School opened its doors on the 13th of January 1930 with Mr. Emmanuel Rampersad as the first principal, Mr. Karim Deacan, the first teacher, and 42 pupils. This day marked the beginning of a purposeful journey to change the lives of the children in the community. An annex was later constructed to accommodate the growing numbers of students at the school. In 1984, the original building was deemed unsafe for use and was broken down to make way for the construction of the new concrete structure that was completed in 1986. When the new school building was completed in 1986, the local board of the Rochard Douglas Presbyterian Church, well supported by the then official board of the Diamond Bar for Pastoral Region, successfully petitioned the PCTT to obtain the then unused annex to serve as a full-time church building. At present, the school's population has grown tremendously, and through the dedication of previous principals, it is classified as one of the prestigious schools in the catchment area of Lengua Barako. The motto of our school is strive for excellence, and we have indeed excelled in many areas. Over the years, leadership and stewardship of this, our beloved school, has changed hands with each principal leaving his or her indelible imprints of achievement on the school in all aspects of education. We all leave footprints as we journey through life. Make sure yours are worth following. By Bob T.
What a beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus. Good morning. Let's come together in prayer. Let us pray. Father Almighty, we thank you that we're able to stand in your presence today to worship and to praise you. And as we go through this service, these moments of inspiration, we ask that your Holy Spirit continue to abide with us, to lead and direct us, to bring us closer to you, that we may have that intimate relationship with you in all things. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Today's scripture reading is taken from Philippians chapter 3, reading from verses 13 to 14. Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth unto those things which are before. I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. This is the word of God. Thanks be to God for his most holy and precious word. Amen.
Bearing all my Members, as we meet for this service of faith and confidence, I invite us all to unite our hearts in prayer. Let us pray. Holy and gracious and loving God, throughout your ministry, you place special emphasis upon the young ones, our sons and our daughters. And Lord God, as we meet this day, pour out your blessing upon their lives. Hear our prayer, for we pray in your wonderful and precious name. Amen. Our text for meditation, Philippians chapter 3, and the verse which says, "So I keep on running and struggling to take hold of the prize." And our topic, putting our faith in God. We have all been called into existence by God. God views us as his own. He says to us, "You are chosen, you are precious, you are valuable, you belong to me." God places special emphasis upon our children. And as we look at the Bible, so many persons have benefited from his love and tender care. He listens. He listens to parents and teachers. He listens to students. And he is here to help us. We meet today for this service of faith and confidence, seeking God's blessings upon your life. Since you entered or started your educational journey, you have been preparing yourself for this undertaking. You have completed the course of study, and you are free to say, "We are ready," or "I am ready." Teachers, you have been sharing information. You have been clarifying. You have been encouraging your students to ensure that they are prepared for the SEA examination. Students, God has given to you, indeed to all of us, the faculties which are needed so as to reach the pinnacle of our career. Yes, you have been storing valuable information. Information which you will be called upon to express and to share. This God whom we worship will bring order to your life. As you enter that examination room, God would bring calm to your hearts. He will give you a remembering spirit, clarity of thought, and freedom of expression. As we meet today, we hold firm to the belief that God, yes, the God whom we worship, is a caring and a loving God, and He desires the best for us. Students, what do you desire for yourselves? Prayer, I will remind you all, prayer is not a substitute for hard work. Prayer is not magic. Students, as a result of your hard work, your perseverance, that spirit of determination, you will be successful. Indeed, as the Word of God tells us, you are being challenged to reach the finish line. And what is the finish line? To go into that examination room and to be successful, you need to press on. God has given to you the inbuilt capacity, and the caring and loving God whom we worship, this God will walk with you to the very end. Hear what Jesus says to us. Ask and you would receive. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door would be open. We heard from the Word of God, which was read to us, where the Apostle Paul, a servant of God, a missionary, a believer, hear what he says. One thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and straining forward in order to receive the prize. He wasn't prepared to be a borderline believer. He was willing to generate the energy in order to be successful. He envisioned the best for himself. His goal brought out the best in him. And God gave him the energy in order to be successful. Students, this is a helpful example for you. Do not allow anything to take your eyes away or to take your eyes off your goal. Hear what the word says. I alone know the plans I have for you. God's Spirit dwells in you. God's Spirit is leading you. And you will be successful. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I invite us all to unite our hearts in prayer. As we see God's blessing upon our sons and our daughters, that God will continue to minister to their hearts, that they would receive the encouragement needed. Holy and gracious and loving God, you know the pulse of our parents, the persistent prayer which they continue to offer. Being the caring and loving God you are, give to them, Lord God, the encouragement which they need at this time. Our Father and our God, as they prepare themselves to write this exam, we know, Lord, that your indwelling power would be at work in their hearts. God, we lift our teachers who are committed, our parents for their unconditional love. Father, whenever we call upon you, you will respond to our need. We place them, O God, in your care and keeping. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you. A special thanks to all the performers today for sharing their musical talents with us. We pray that God will continue to bless your ministry in music as you share the message of Christ everywhere that you go. Thank you to our moderator, the Right Reverend Daniel Chance, for that encouraging message of faith and confidence. We pray that God continues to guide you as you fulfill the mission in this part of God's vineyard. Dear friends, as we come to the end of today's episode, we thank you for spending this moment with us, and we pray that today's message has touched your hearts. We encourage you to visit our YouTube channel, Presbyterian Church, Trinidad and Tobago, where you can find all our episodes uploaded. You can also like and follow us on Facebook at Moments of Inspiration or on Instagram using the handle Presbyterian Church TT. We also welcome you to join us in person on Sunday mornings at our 108 congregations nationwide. If you have any further questions about the Presbyterian Church, please do not hesitate to contact us via our website at www.pcTT.org.tt. I leave you now with today's moment of inspiration.
To our sons and daughters, as you prepare to write the Secondary Entrance Assessment, S.E.A., as a church, we pray God's blessing upon you. Take confidence in knowing that you will never walk alone. God walks with you. Blessings.